Welcome back. Today we're going to look at supercollider synthesizers. This isn't something I know a lot about. My expertise is more on the pattern side. SuperDirt is something that Julian Rorabeh made. Originally it was a piece of C code that I wrote, but then he re-implemented it all in supercollider, making it much better. But personally, I'm not so good at making synthesizers. I have made some unit generators for SuperCollider, the membrane synthesizers, which are based on waveguide synthesis, but that's written in C. I'm not so good at the SuperCollider side. It's too close to maths for my brain, I think. I can show you how to get started, and then later on I think Eris is going to do a video for us. She has a lot more expertise, so we'll be able to go into greater depth. Right, that's the plan. Let's get into the code. So here's a nice thread that's just appeared. Peter Jagielski has contributed a nice list of SuperCollider synths which are available. So let's have a look at this. This is Diego, a great Tidal cyclist. He's got a nice collection here. Let's pick this one. So this is what a SuperCollider synthesizer looks like. Surprisingly little amount of code, but it's pretty dense stuff. But some combination of oscillators and things which wobble together in sympathy with each other in order to create sound. So all I'm going to do is copy that, including the parenthesis. Oh, missed one. Yeah, parenthesis at the top and bottom. And then go into SuperCollider and paste it in. Actually, it's still there from earlier when I was practicing, but let's pretend that was blank and I've just pasted it in. And there it is. So I'll restart SuperCollider. So I'm starting from a blank slate. There we go. So that's started. Listening to Tidal, all good. And let's run it. So if you put your cursor on the bracket, you'll see the whole thing. You might not see it that well, actually, but the whole thing is sort of grayed out because this whole thing is selected. Which means that now if I do Control Enter, it might be Command Enter on a Mac. I'm not sure. Try them all until it works. You'll see it all flashes, and now we see a synth def. So that means that the definition of a synthesizer has been compiled and sent to the SuperCollider synthesizer, and it's now running. So that's all you need to do to get that running. Pretty straightforward. And now I can go to Atom. So this is called CS80 Lead. That's the name of the synth. And that's the name of the sound here. So I just put CS80 Lead. Run that. And then hash it. These days with the latest version of Atom, you can just do Control and Dot, or probably Command and Dot on a Mac. To hash, so I don't have to type hash all the time, which is a bonus. So there we go, it's already playing. So I could choose a different note. I could add a bit crush. I could add some reverb. So straight away I've started off with what was already quite a nice synth sound, and then it's just adding a couple of effects. It's starting to sound quite unique, which is great. Let's just make it a bit shorter. There we go. Now there is a bit of a problem I've noticed with this synth. You might not hear it unless you're listening on headphones or something like that, but you might be able to hear a little click at the end of the sound. Let's see. OK, Can you hear that click? So that means there's something wrong with the envelopes. Now, again, this isn't something I understand completely. What I do know is that SuperDirt likes to take care of the envelopes for you. So here we can see it's got an envelope here, and another one here. By envelope, this is kind of the envelope in this case, which is being applied to the volume of the sound. So when you listen to a sound, it has a kind of attack. If it's a soft attack, like a violin, then it'll sort of go zzz. If it's like a drum, then you'll hear that kind of fast attack. And then if it's something like a guitar, it'll have a long tail to it, so it'll have a long sustain. And this is what's called the envelope, the kind of shape of that that kind of volume curve. And this has got envelopes in it. And so all I'm going to do is remove them. So this was multiplied by that envelope. I'm just going to remove that. And there's an envelope here. I'm going to remove that. And I've just put two slashes here, which comments out those. I could just delete them, actually. And then this is live coding as well, so I can just run it again. It'll say a synth def, but it's replaced the previous version. And now if I run this, the click's gone. So I could still change the shape of it by, for example, adding sustain. I think this works. Yeah. So I think that's where the click comes from, a kind of interference between the envelope that the synthesizer was trying to add and the envelope which SuperDirt adds for you. Yeah, if that's unclear, then ask some questions and we can see if Julian or someone else can help us out with the answers. So the standard SuperDirt effects are there. So as I showed, but the thing is that this synth has some extra ones like detune, vibrate. We should be able to pattern these as well. Let's try. So if we put detune, the default was 0.002, but let's try something a bit higher, 0.5. Ah, doesn't work. Variable not in scope detune. So Tidal doesn't know about this parameter. In that case, you can just tell it what it is. You can say PF, which means it's a parameter of type floating point. So that's the floating point there. So it's a decibel number. So now we should be able to change that. There. Sounds good. So, but maybe that's a bit annoying to have to keep doing the PF thing. And so what you can do is detune equals PF detune at the top. And I've run that. So now I can just use it the same as any other parameter. If I remember to do double quotes. Okay. You could put that inside your boot title file if you wanted. If this is something that you use all the time, then you can find out where your boot title is by looking at the startup log, and then file, open it, and then is that going to work? Oh yes. And then just put it at the bottom. Actually, there's a nice list of definitions here, so I could just add it to this. So I could put detune equals PF detune. And now I've saved that, so if I restart Tidal, which I think I can do here, reboot Tidal cycles, then I don't have to run that anymore. So that's how to customize, add some extra custom stuff to Tidal. So that's just added that extra parameter. So we could do the same with the other parameter, like vibrate. I have so many strange things going on, it's hard to hear. And I could do the same thing like this. So vibrate equals PF vibrate. And I could add that to my boot tidal as well. Why not do it while I'm talking to you? Doesn't take that long. There you go. Right, so that is that. The only other thing is how to have it so this starts up every time. So if you really like this synthesizer, which actually I do, then you can open your startup file. So I've just copied that. I haven't included the parenthesis at the start and stop, just the synth def itself. So I've done copy, and now I can go to open startup file. Here it is. And this is the code that's run on startup. So I'm just going to try putting it here. There. So this is the SuperDirt boot up. But this, I think, can just go outside of that. So before the final bracket, which was already there, I've just pasted it in at the bottom. So now if I restart SuperDirt, which you can do with recompile class library. Think. Hopefully that's loaded. Let's check. So there you go. There's a lot more synthesizers to explore. If you start getting that clicking, then play around the envelopes, and if you get stuck, just ask a question, and hopefully someone more knowledgeable will help out. If not me, I'll do my best, and have fun with this. See you later.